ha választhatnék mind a között, ha szabadon és kötöttség nélkül választhatnék, akkor szeretnék egy jó egyetemi tanár lenni, aki államelméletet tanít. Politológiát, államelméletet. Ehhez volna kedvem leginkább, úgy érzem. Tehát én azt, hogy elmenjek zárt ajtók mögé tárgyalni, és hogy politikai eredményt érjek el 8 órai kemény tárgyalásokkal, ehhez nekem nincsen kedvem. Szóval ez nem az én világom.
I just translate. He thought that he would like to be a university teacher.
Actually, not much changed since 89, just the climate changed a bit.
Climate changed a lot. I mean, it's Hungarian much, society.
Actually, it's really fucking cold in Hungarian society.
Basically, you have to directly die in solidarity, of course. Come on, you are activist, so you should know that.
Yeah, you said the climate is changing, nothing else. So we need the same kind of activism, or a new kind of activism today as well.
Yeah, but what do you want to change? I mean, the climate already has changed, so climate changing.
Just the small things like the system or the political, economical.
I think there are many, many devoted people who want to do something, who feel, for example, morally obligated to do something. And with Extinction Rebellion, the Hungarian group, I can see myself that in a short time, a really close, almost group of friends formed out of this climate crisis. So if we think in bigger ways, maybe the society in a whole can come together.
Giving up freedom, they go to prison voluntarily, I heard. Like, so they want to go to prison. I mean, we also were in prison several times. On your table, please discuss, find one freedom to give up. If you come up with a proposal and a common agreement, which freedom would you give up?
It's a necessary thing for the activists, for the rebels, to be arrested, because mass arrests, like a couple of hundred arrests, make a political statement.
It's coming through a hole in the air from those nights in Tiananmen Square.
We went on streets every day.
I feel that this ain't exactly real, or it's real, but it ain't exactly there. From the war against disorder, from the sirens night and day, from the fires of the homeless, from the ashes of the gay, democracy is coming.
I think there's hope that people see that we have to form a community, that we need each other and we depend on each other, and without this we'll have a really dark future.
It's come through a crack in the wall, a Navy Genera flood of alcohol, from the staggering account of the Sermon on the Mount, which I don't pretend to understand at all. It's coming from the silence on the dock of the bay, from the brave, the bold, the battered heart of Chevrolet. Democracy is coming.